Hey, it's Allison from computers.mom, and this quick video will show you how to add a signature, or more than one if you want, to your Gmail. It's quick and easy to do, and it can both save you a lot of typing and make your email look more professional. As usual with our videos, don't worry about taking notes as you watch because you'll find a one-page recap of the steps at the end of the video. To get started, open a web browser on your computer, whichever one you normally use, Chrome, Microsoft Edge, or in this case, Safari. When the browser window appears, open Gmail. I'm going to use the link right here on the Google page, or you can type gmail.com into the address bar. For the purposes of this video, we're assuming that you know how to get to your Gmail account and that you're already signed in. Once you're looking at the main Gmail page like this, click on the gear icon on the upper right to open Settings. That brings up this pane with some common settings, but not the ones we need. So you'll need to click here on See All Settings. And here we are at the main settings page for this Gmail account. There are a gazillion options, and more all the time as Google adds features. Notice that there are tabs across the top of this page. You can poke around in the various tabs and options and settings anytime. I often find useful features when I do. But for right now, the signature settings are on the General tab. So make sure it is blue, meaning that's the one you're seeing. Now scroll way down the page to find the signature section. There are currently no signatures on this account, so let's click Create New. First, we give the signature a descriptive name. It can be something obvious like My Signature or whatever makes sense to you, up to 320 characters long. You can see the count as you type. When you finish typing the name, click the blue Create button. Now that it has a name, we type the contents of the signature in this box. Notice that at the bottom of the box, you have a bunch of formatting options like bold, italic, underline, text color, and so on, just like you do in an email. This window isn't big enough to see all of them, even if I make it wider, but if you click the little arrow at the end, you can see the rest of them. So you can play around with the formatting of the signature if you want. One of my favorite options here is to add a link to the signature. For example, if I want to make it easy for people I email to visit my YouTube channel, I just select the appropriate text, click the link button right here, and enter the address of my YouTube channel. You can copy and paste into this box too. You don't have to type in the URL. Let's add some italics to the tagline and make the name bold, and we can even change the color of the text or the text background, whatever looks good to you. Once you're happy with the signature, you might want to add another one for a different purpose, like one for work and one for personal use, or whatever you need. Let's quickly add a second signature just for the purposes of this example, and we will also zoom in so you can see better. Now that we have two to play around with, there are three more options to consider. We need to choose which signature is the default, the one that shows up automatically, both for new emails that you initiate and for replies. And make sure that this box, Insert Signature Before Quoted Text, is checked. I'll show you why in a moment. Finally, be sure to scroll down and click this not very obvious little button at the bottom of the page that says Save Changes, or you'll lose all the work you just did. Clicking Save Changes takes you back out of settings to your inbox. So now we can test our new signatures. Click Compose to create a new email, and you see that the default signature we selected automatically appears at the bottom of the message area. If you want to use a different signature in an email, all you have to do is click this little pen icon in the formatting toolbar, which is the Insert Signatures button. A menu pops up, letting you choose any signature you have saved, or no signature at all, and it even has a link to go to the signature settings. And finally, let's try replying to an email. Notice that the signature appears above the quoted text of the email we are replying to, indicated by the three dots or ellipsis right here. When you reply, the original email is normally quoted below your message, as you probably know, and we don't want our signature at the very bottom of the whole thing. We want it above the quoted text, below what we are writing. That was the purpose of that checkbox I pointed out earlier. So that's all there is to it. Here's a quick recap of the steps as promised. To add signatures to your Gmail, start by opening your Gmail account in whichever web browser you normally use, Chrome, Edge, Firefox, Safari, etc. click the gear icon on the upper right corner, and then click See All Settings. Make sure you're on the General tab in Settings and scroll down to the Signature section. Create and format whatever signatures you want and then choose which one will be the default for both new emails and replies, and check the box to keep your signature at the end of your message, not the bottom of the whole reply. Finally, scroll to the bottom of the page and click Save Changes, and you're done. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave comments and questions below. Click like if you found this helpful, and don't forget to subscribe for more Computers.Mom videos.